So students, today you are going to see how hemoglobin concentration we can estimate by the way of Sandmuth hemoglobin method. So previously, in the previous video, I have discussed about the procedure and the materials used for the hemoglobin estimation by means of the Challis method. But in this case, it is somehow different because that Challis method was totally manual with maybe a few amount of errors, which are known as the manual error. But the error percentage is much more less in case of this, because we are going to measure, or we are going to get the actual value by using the colonimeter. So first of all, I am going to demonstrate that what are the material used when we are going to estimate the hemoglobin by Sandmuth method. So first of all, you can see that this is a machine. This is called colonimeter. Okay, so it is an electric machine. You can see that your plug over here, how it works and how the calibration is set, what is the green filter and all, we will see when it will work. So number two, come into this. So this is the solution we are going to use. You can see that here written hemocyan. Actually, it's commonly known as drop king solution. And you can see also here written hemoglobin reagent. That means it's a reagent that is used for the estimation of the hemoglobin by Sandmuth method. So this is a sample you can see with purple cap, vial. So this is the pipette. So it is a 5 ml pipette. You probably see the 5 ml is written here. So it's a 5 ml pipette, and what you have to do, that when you will pick up the reagent, that means the Dropkins reagent, you have to take 5 ml. But it may not always be possible for you to take the 5 ml or pick up the 5 ml or pipette the 5 ml as a whole. So you can do one thing, that you can take up to 2.5 ml twice. So 2.5 ml plus 2.5 ml is equal to 5 ml. That's also a way by which you can do, and I think it will be much more flawless. This is the test tube where we will allow to do the reaction between the blood and the Dropkin solution. Now this is a micropipette. Okay, it can be adjusted by using this knob. Now it is set at 10, because we are going to take the solution as 2.5. So when we will take it as a whole as 5 ml, then we will set it at 20. So this is the thing you have to keep it in your mind. Today we are going to take the Dropkin solution as, because 2.5 ml. So today the micropipette is set at 10. When you will do the this experiment with the 5 ml of Dropkin solution, then you can set it by 20, like okay. So this is the way how the micropipette can be set. So this is the knob which you can turn clockwise to set it. So now we will do the procedure accordingly. So students, now we will see the procedure of estimation of hemoglobin by Sandmuth method. Mr. Dhananjay Chakraborty, our lab technician, will do that, and I will describe step by step. So first of all, we have to take 2.5 ml of Dropkin solution. What he is doing, that he is taking the Dropkin solution by using a pipette and a rubber tip. So you can see here that no mouth pipetting is allowed, because it's very much dangerous for health. So 2.5 ml is taken, and it is transferred into the test tube. You can see the color of the solution, Dropkin solution. It's somehow different from water, slightly yellowish in color. So first step we have completed.
Now we will take the sample that is kept in the purple capped vial with the help of the micropipette, and then the further step I will describe. So it is set at 10. Yeah, it is set at 10. So he is picking up the blood. You can see how much blood is taken. Outer side of the piece is cleared, and now the total blood is dipped into the Dropkin solution by frequent punching, so that all the blood can go inside the Dropkin solution. So it's mixed well and it is kept for 10 minutes for the reaction to be completed. So now we will within these 10 minutes we will prepare our colorimeter. Now let us see how we prepare the colorimeter now. So now students, we will see that how the colorimeter is set, how the green filter is set, etc. Dhananjay will demonstrate that. So you can see that he is setting the green filter. The green filter is kept at 52. You can see that. Now he is taking some distilled water and okay. So it is wiped properly because it is going to insert into the particular part in the colorimeter. You can see he will insert that, so it is very much necessary to keep it properly. You can see that after inserting, the numerics are changing gradually. Now he is setting the blank. It should be at 0. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. So the green filter is set at 52, you can see. And now the blank is set at 0. So this is the setup of the colorimeter, which will help us to determine the hemoglobin percentage by Sandmeth method. So we kept that particular test tube for 10 minutes for the reaction to be completed. In the meantime, we have completed our setup of colorimeter. Now we will proceed some step further. Now from that solution, few amount is taken in a different type of test tube. You can see that these two test tubes are not same. Dhananjay, please show. Okay, you can see there is a difference in the length and difference in the diameter also. So these two are not same, okay. So enough amount of solution is taken. It's wiped out thoroughly because now we are going to insert it into the colorimeter to take the reading. So it is inserted, and now you can see the colorimeter is what the reading is given by the colorimeter, 0.24. This value we will use in the calculation to calculate the hemoglobin value of that particular sample. So students, now you will see about the calculation of hemoglobin estimation by Sandmeth hemoglobin method. So this calculation is somehow different than we have done in the Shelley's method. So here we will use a formula. Now what is the formula? Hemoglobin concentration, that is our aim, which we have to find out in gram per dl. You can see gram per dl. Now what is the formula? Absorbance of S minus absorbance of blank. That means what is that? What is that? Is that what we have seen in the colorimeter value? That is 0.24.
Now, absorbance of standard minus absorbance of blank, that is 0.36, it is already been detected in the laboratory from the very early of the experiment. Now, into concentration of the standard, that is 15.06, it is the value which is supplied when we buy the Drapkin solution reagent. That means it is supplied from the company itself. So, what we have to do? We have to just assemble these values and we have to calculate the value. So, what is that? 0.26 divided by 0.36 into 15.06 gram per dl. So, what is the value? 10.04 gram per dl. And the sample was of a female. So, we know that normally the hemoglobin concentration in case of the female is 10 to 12 gram per dl. So, considering that, it is just reaching the value. We can say that the patient or the person is slightly anemic in nature.